All right, so I'm gonna start Alwa's Awakening right now. I don't remember what I've been doing, so I'm going to, it's been a long time. I'm going to delete my first save file, and I'm just going to start over. Alright. The land of Alwa was once a beautiful and peaceful place, filled with vivid lakes, clear skies, and lush forests. The people living there were free. They took care of one another, and together ensured the safety of the land. But one day, the peace was broken. Someone wanted Alwa for himself, and a mystical being known as Vicar descended from above. Armed not by weapons, but instead driven by hate, he slowly began to enslave the people of Alwa. No one could escape his reach. Vicar formed the protectors. Together, they sought to claim the ornaments, which are said to give their owner immense power. The ornaments had always been in the hands of the people, safe from evil. With them captured by Vicar, all seemed lost. Under the demonic reign of Vicar, the people of Alwa were helpless, and his evil quickly spread throughout the land. The village where the ornaments were kept was destroyed, and hope was gone. Soon began a darkness that would last for centuries. But things are about to change. The people of Alwa have chosen to fight, and from another world, a heroine has been sent for. Might be me. Wake up, Zo. The eternal flame must be lit. Hello, Zo. You are in the land of Alwa. I am Saga, and I have brought you here to help us. Alwa has been enslaved by evil, and we, the people, have lost our strength and courage to fight back. We cannot do this alone. You must help us. You are stronger than us, and in time, you will uncover your true strength. You must enter this tower and go all the way to the top in order to find the magic staff. When you have found the staff, quickly make your way back to town. But watch out. There are many dangerous foes out there. Wait, so basically, I've been brought to this world against my will, and I'm being forced to fight? That seems kind of sketchy. I think this might be the staff. I found a magic staff. When I hold it, you can feel there is something really special with this item. Use it with attack to fight enemies and to destroy certain walls. Okay, so why is my attack? Where'd that old lady go? She couldn't have gotten through there. Right. Amber Sacculum. Go and light the flame in the center of this room. Doing so will let you start from here if your venture comes to an end. Alright, so that's the saving spot. I'm gonna go up first. Just to see what's there. Let's try and actually hit the jump button on time. I don't think I can jump that high yet. No, I'm not gonna make that jump yet. Okay, so I gotta be able to get higher for that. Didn't mean to do that. Oh, hi John. I see that the Canadians won again today. I never thought that they would be up 3-0 over Winnipeg. I thought for sure Winnipeg would be the team ahead in this series before they started. So now I've come somewhere to which I can't get back. At least not until I'm able to jump higher. But I might as well save. What's down this way? What's this night guy over here say? Beyond this door, you will find Amber Sacculum, the first step on your journey. In there, you will find a green gemstone and a very powerful enemy. When you have found the stone and defeated the evil, go back to town. This dungeon is very dangerous, so you'll need a map. First, you should go talk to Platt in the town of Westwood, then pick up the map. Do that and I will let you in. Alright, let's go find a map. This music is very catchy. I'm getting it stuck in my head already. I thought I should be able to make that jump. I'm gonna try one more time. Still can't make it up there, but that's okay. Left, Void Tower. Right, Town of Westwood. Welcome, Zoo. This is the Town of Westwood. Thank you for coming to the land of Alwa. You have been sent for because we are weak. You must help us destroy the evil that threatens our land. Go back to the cave just outside town and talk to the knight. He will open the entrance to the Amber Saclum. There you will find a green gemstone and a very powerful enemy. But before you go, enter this house where you can find a map of Alwa. It will guide you in your journey. Now go, Zo, and return when you found the green gemstone and defeated the evil enemy. I don't like the fact that they basically forced me to come to this land, and I have to save it for them. I found a map. If I check my inventory now, it shows my location. Go on, try it out. Alright. I don't know what I did there. But I have the map. Well, I don't know what I did, but now that I have the map, I am ready. When I found the green gemstone, the evil is defeated, go back to town. Alright. And let me open this door for you. Amber Saclum. Saclum? Something. Nope, can't make that jump yet. It looks like it might be the boss, because it's got like a skully type thing on that door. This seems sketchy. I have to do anything to him yet. Yeah, so now I'm back near where I started. So if I look at my map, yep. This is a nice game. That was close. I almost got hit there. I'm noticing that I have a slight little bit of input lag. Like there, where I hit the jump button, but I didn't register it. Oh, I can't jump that high yet. I don't think I can go this way yet, because I'm going to get hurt if I try and do that. I guess I have 2-3 hit points I could try. Oh, I would have made it. But, yeah. I'm probably going to die a bunch in this game, but that's okay. Let's try that again. We'll risk getting two hits. Everybody else has been one hit before. Okay. We'll keep going. I don't want to go back down there again yet. We're going to go this way. Because I can still go to the right there. Okay, so I have to go down. It seems kind of poor that I have to... I'm forced to make a jump that's gonna hurt me. Doesn't seem right. I can't afford to make that jump now because I can't get hit twice. Actually, singing to this until I get a hit. I need healing. Give me some healing. There we go. I'm sure that's not the right thing to do, but I don't see what else I can do there at the moment. Yeah, so he's a two-hit kind of guy. Found the green gemstone. It glows with a mysterious light. I place it on my staff and it fits perfectly. Now I can hold up and press attack to create gemstone blocks. Every time I create a block, it uses magic, so you have to wait your magic meter to be refilled before you can create another block. No! Oh. Do I still have my magic block? Oh, I do. Good. can't jump that high. Made it. No. I'm gonna have a pretty high death count by the time I finish this game. That's okay. I thought that one would follow me when I stood on it. That seems awfully suspicious, but I don't have the ability to get up there. Have you seen any blue orbs lying around? They are very powerful, and if you see any, you should try to collect them. The more you have, the more powerful you become when fighting the protectors. Huh. There's also a treasure hidden somewhere in this dungeon. You should really try to find it before you leave. How dare you enter these chambers? Why have you come to this land to destroy us? We have done nothing to you. That's right, you have done nothing to me. You should show Vicar your divine honor and respect. He is the only true deity. But enough talk. Have at you. This game wasn't made with Canadian English because we spell honor with a U. I think I'm gonna die. I don't think I did that right. Okay. So that started you just running up to him and attacking. It's not gonna work. That might work. Alright, I have an idea. If I don't get hit. I got hit twice in that first one. I didn't notice that. I gotta pay attention to my health. Gonna have a lot of deaths just trying to figure out this boss. But I have some ideas. Haha, success. I don't think I'm going to find that secret item that's in there. We'll save again. Once again, jumping or delaying the jump button. Now that you have the green gemstone, you can continue to the east. There you will find the Shrine of Sea Monk. All right. I know a lot of things, so come talk to me if you ever need help. Do not stare too long at the light. Is broken and you cannot pass, but if you have the green gemstone, you can create a block that lets you pass. Hello. In this well next to me, you can refill your water, but first you need to find something to carry it in. No, this is... Sorry, I missed your first message. This isn't on SNES. This is a Switch game called Alwa's Awakening. But it has SNES-style graphics. Definitely has that kind of feel to it. The company that developed this game is called Elden Pixels, and they've created a sequel called Alwa's Legacy. I shouldn't have jumped so quick. Gotta be quick, but not that quick. And that time I missed hitting the jump button. Good night. Thank you. Come stop by again sometime and or catch it later. It's fine. I jumped right into that one. I was told I have to go east, which is the way that I'm going, but I'm dying when I go east. I can't do anything there yet. left ember cyclone, right underground chamber. I can't go right yet, but if I do that... Now I can always come back that way. Okay. I didn't mean to jump down all there, but once I did, it was too late. Trying to do was climb down so that that guy would be low enough that I could go like that. Floats. Oh. That doesn't float. You know, you went to all this trouble to summon me from this other world, but you didn't bother to summon somebody who could swim? Oh, I doubted myself and fell backwards. Not getting up there yet. I want to get restore my health. Now I really want to restore my health. Watch, I'm gonna kill myself trying to get extra health. One more try, and then I'm gonna give up. Okay, no more getting health from him. try this again. Jump, 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 jump. Left. Solstice Mountain. Down. Underground Chamber. Right. Gloom Lake. No, I can't make those to go in the water, so I can't go that way. Can't get up there. I can't make more than one orb, so. Can't float my orbs yet, so I can't even be down here. Alright, let's leave. So I didn't mean to go back that far. While I'm here, I might as well see if I can get health. Nope. Okay. I stood too close to the edge. Thank you. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is go to the teleporter. Didn't mean to go there. Meant to go to Central Alwa. So I couldn't go that way, I don't think. Okay, when I hit 20 deaths, I'm gonna call it for tonight. I'm not sure which way I'm supposed to go. Last try for tonight. I'm gonna go explore somewhere else. I'm gonna go back to the Forbidden City. Or Forbidden. Forsaken Valley. That was quite interesting. I feel like I can make that jump. I can't go there. missed time to jump. I'm gonna try and find out what's over there in that one spot. I don't understand how I made it that one time, but not any other times. There we go. Made it. So I must have to do stuff over in Central Alwa. I just can't figure it out. And I don't think I feel up to it today. Yeah, save. Haha, got past you. Take that, you. Right, Gloom Lake. This is the entrance to the last challenge of your journey, Zoe. Or so. In order to open this, you need the power of the protectors. Do you want me to tell you about the four protectors? No. That was close, because I very likely could have died there. This looks like it's a save point. It is good. There's a treasure hidden in the Amber's column. If you bring it to me, I can open this door for you. That'll be it for tonight. Thank you for joining me. I hope to continue more of this. It's pretty fun. Alright. Thank you very much, and...